Welcome to Checking In With, presented by O'Neill. We are with Team Face Billy Laninovich, who's made quite a splash as a 40-year-old in this year's Monster Energy Supercross Series. So we talked before the season on the SML show, and I think you checked off a few of the bucket list items, right?
I did. Yeah, being able to go out and qualify for the mains. Wish I could have done a little bit better, but for the circumstances, I honestly rode, I think, 11 or 12 times of Supercross since A1. Haven't been on the track very much, just getting landed on in San Diego. I was really banged up and just had to show up to the races A2 and Arizona. But yeah, to get in the mains at 40, I wanted to really do it because I turned 41 in February. But ended up falling. I was going to do Dallas and Daytona on a 450. And I was breaking this bike in and just tucked the front end. Real slow crash and just landed really, really hard and broke my rib. And it's been taking forever to heal. So I've ridden about a handful of times. And then about 2 weeks ago, I was riding at Fox. Took a deep breath over a jump. And I don't know if I re-broke it or something, but it was just like I just broke it.
Maybe so, it was the cartilage between the ribs or something.
Yeah, it was something. I mean, I couldn't even sit down on the side of the track on my bike. It hurt so bad. So first day back from that and actually feel pretty good.
Okay, so will we see you anymore in Supercross this year?
I don't know. With having all this time off, if I can get on a track next week, at least get a couple weeks of riding in on Supercross, I'll think about it. Being off like I am, I've lost all my fitness, at least on the bike, you know. And it's gnarly out there. It's no joke. And I don't want to go out there half-assed and end up hurting myself trying to keep up with these boys and stuff. So it's still up in the air. I'm working on that and still thinking about next year. Maybe doing it next year, too.
Next year. Maybe 42 partway through the season.
42 in February, yeah.
So what was the biggest difference in Supercross now versus then? Was it the tracks, the bikes, or everything?
Hey, stop it. No, probably back in the day, doing track walk, everyone, dude, get up there.
Hey, he don't like scrub day. That's what he's barking at that guy.
No, he don't like cameras.
Oh, okay.
It's the camera. Stop. The biggest difference is all the guys were wearing baggy bell-bottom jeans, and now everything is super, super tight, looking like chicks out there. Yeah. No, the tracks are the same. They were pretty mellow, probably until, Arizona? They were pretty peaked out, big rhythm sessions.
Mm-hmm.
But the bikes are so much better. Probably got 10 to 15 more horsepower than back in the day.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's the biggest difference. And then I don't know what it is about the West Coast rounds, man. I'm back when I was racing, the Anaheim, San Diego, all those tracks were hard as a rock. There was no ruts in them.
And we've had a wet year.
This year, maybe because of the rain, dirt softer. I don't know if they got to do something different at Supercross, but it was like riding the East Coast track. So for me going to ride Yamaha, we got tiny little ruts. And then get to A1 and there's five ruts in the corners up the face of the jumps. It was a little different, but man, it was fun. I had a blast doing it. Wish I could have stayed a little bit healthier.
I think you got a lot of media attention. You see a lot of TV time.
Yeah, it was awesome.
But how was the fan support and reception?
Oh, they loved it. It was mainly guys my age, a little bit older. Kids didn't know who I was, but it was the dads that were super, super stoked on it.
Nice.
It gave them motivation. I got a lot of messages about guys that hadn't been to a race in a really long time that came out to watch or started riding again, hadn't ridden in 10 or 15 years, and got them motivated to get back on a bike and do some racing.
Nice. All right, so I guess in conclusion, what's the rest of 2024 look like for you? Are you going to hit a national or two?
No, I was thinking maybe do the first couple, Paula and Fox, or Fox and Hangtown, but with me not being able to ride, there's no way. 30 plus two laps when the track's rough and hot. It's just, so just going to be coaching. I've got my Lano MX University, coaching the boys, getting some of them ready for Loretta's and some of these nationals coming up. And like I said, hopefully, you know, hopefully next week I can try to get on a Supercross track. I feel good here. Hurts a little bit, but not too bad. I just don't know how the hard hits and the whoops are going to be on my rib. So just play it by ear and see how it goes.
Nice. Good seeing you, buddy.
Good to see you, too. Thanks.